Some might call it either the new focus on ethnic sensitivity or even political correctness. Now, a popular national treat in the Netherlands is a cookie or tea biscuit called Jorenkoeken. It's a shortbread dish whose Dutch name literally means Jew cookies. Well, this weekend, though, the company behind the country's oldest and best-known Jorenkoeken brand announced that it was changing the cookie's name in a bid to help create a, quote, more inclusive society, and there are reports that other companies that make them are also considering a name switch. Well, for more on this, we're joined from Amsterdam by Yona Freud, a culinary journalist and cookbook author. Yona, thanks for joining us. First of all, what is exactly a Jorenkoeken or a Jew cookie, and how did it get that name? I understand there are different theories on that.
There are a lot of stories about it. One of the stories is that a formal Jewish baker started to bake it more than a century ago, and that he sold the recipe to some real baker, some bakers in the north of Holland, and that they start to bake it and call it a Jodenkoekje. A Jew, Jode is also the word for Jew. It's the word for Jews in the Netherlands. But that's only one of the stories. Another story is that there has been a baker whose name was De Jode with a double O. And that's the other story, and that's why the cookie has this name. But there is also, more or less, another story that it's because it's flat like a matzah. That's the reason why it's this name. I must say, the photo you have over there, I don't think that someone over here should recognize it as a Jodenkoek.
What is a Dutch Jodenkoek look like, actually?
I have a picture only from a book, not from the... I can show you. I hope you can see it all.
Okay.
Oh, a little bit lower.
Kind of looks like a British digestive.
More like that. But it's a very sweet and very soft cookie.
Right.
And it has a diameter from 10 centimeters.
Okay. So let me ask you, until now, has the Jodenkoekje, has it had some kind of negative connotation? I mean, I know there are other, I actually am married to a Dutch woman, and I know a little about Holland. I know there are other nicknames used in Dutch culture, for example, regarding the Ajax football club. There are some negative connotations, but is the Jodenkoekje, has that been seen somewhat negatively until now?
I never heard of it, but I must say there has been someone in 1970, so that's 50 years ago now, who also tried to change the name. But that was the last thing I've heard about it. And for me, it was also news this weekend that they changed the name into an Jodenkoek, Ode, which means in the Netherlands, a tribute to. But I must say I think it's publicity for the company who makes them. That's what I think.
Okay, well, we're certainly giving them publicity, but there does seem to be some kind of precedent for this. I read that there was a dessert which was popularly called, you correct me if I'm wrong, Jodenvat, which was a kind of Dutch candy, which means literally Jew fat. I don't understand the connection at all, and that the name was changed. Are you familiar with that story?
No, not at all. The only thing I can imagine is that they're talking about goose fat or something then. But no, I've never heard about Jodenvat. There are, especially from Amsterdam, there lived a lot of Jews before World War II, and there were a lot of things. We have Amsterdam's sour, that is a little onions, pickled onions. And that was typical a Jew dish, and it still remains like it. We call it ossewurst. It's made from veal. So we have a lot of dishes in our culture who are coming from the dishes the Jews used to make over here. So that's, but I never heard about stories that they want to change names.
I do want to put it slightly in a bigger context, Yonah. I do know that in Holland there has been some discussion and controversy over some of the terms, for example, about the Sinterklaas holiday and Schwarze Piet, which is a Black Peter, which some have seen as a sort of racial and ethnic stereotype, and that has become sort of raised a lot of discussion in Holland about some of these traditional names. Do you think this could be a kind of offshoot of that, meaning it's the controversy over that could have sort of spilled over into someone saying, well, maybe Jodin Kolkin is could be seen as offensive to some people or even to some Jews?
It's absolutely possible that people are making the same quotation on it. But I think that only two or three people are asking for it, that a company is going to think about it. And maybe they're going to have a talk it over, and then they think, yeah, we have to stop this. But I never heard from this one. I've worked a lot with bakers, and I've wrote books about cookies and about the bakeries here in the Netherlands, and I've never heard from a baker who was interested in changing the name. Until now. And I must also say that maybe when you're walking into a supermarket, that there are people now who think, yo, the cookie, that's strange. Why they call a cookie like that? But it already exists 100 years, a cookie. And I think everyone now is talking about the Jode Koeken, or better now, Ode Koeken. And I think that's the main issue for the company.
Right.
That's what I think.
Right. I understand it's one of the main companies that it makes this kind of cookie. Do you think the other companies now are going to have to follow suit, or they'll just leave it as Jode Koeken?
I heard today that the other companies are also thinking about it now, yeah. I think that they have to call it all the same then.
All right.
But what I say is, the most important thing that they don't change the taste of the cookie, because it's a very important taste.
Okay, so either as a Jode Koeken or Ode Koeken, whatever, maybe you'll have to use...
You said when you started to introduce me that we are in Holland, we have the greatest mix on cookies of the world. We are special with our cookies.
I know. My wife bakes me speculaas, so I certainly know that.
I mean that, yeah.
Okay, Yonah Freud, thank you for joining us on The Rundown.
Okay, thank you.